Next, we have the disqualification of membership. A person shall be disqualified for being chosen as and for being a member of either House of Parliament if he holds any office of profit under the Government of India or the government of any state, but not a minister for the union or for a state. So if a member of Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, if he holds an executive post under the central government or the state government, he will be disqualified of the membership of the Lok Sabha. Now, second disqualification, if he is of unsound mind and stands so declared by a competent court. Now, competent court is a court that has the authority to do a certain act. Now, if a person is declared that he is mentally not fit, he is insane by any of the competent court, then in that case also the person is disqualified of the membership of Lok Sabha. Third, if he is an undischarged insolvent. Undischarged insolvent means the person is still under heavy debt. He is he has not yet paid off his debts. So under such circumstance also the person is disqualified of the membership. Now the fourth point is given on the next page. If he is not a citizen of India or has voluntarily acquired citizenship of a foreign state. So fourth condition in which he will be disqualified is if he is not a citizen of India. And next one, if he has willingly acquired the citizenship of some other country or is under an acknowledgement of allegiance or adherence to a foreign power. Now if he has accepted the commitment to a group, cause or belief of some other country. In such case also, the person or the member will be disqualified. Now the last point is, if he is so disqualified by or under any law made by the Parliament. Now in any question, if any question arises as to whether a member of either House of Parliament has become subject to any of the above disqualifications, the President's decision in accordance with the opinion of the Election Commission shall be final. So if a member of either house, that is Lok Sabha or the Rajya Sabha, has become a subject to any of the above disqualifications which we just read, the President has got a power that he can take a decision in accordance with the opinion of the Election Commission whether that member should continue in the house or not. And not only this, a penalty of rupees 500 per day may be imposed upon a person who sits or votes in either House of Parliament knowing that he is not qualified or that he is disqualified for the membership thereof. And if a person on purpose sits for the meetings and he casts votes, even after being not qualified or disqualified, he shall have to pay a penalty or fine of rupees 500 per day. Our next heading is vacation of seats. In what conditions the seats are vacant? The seat of a member of either House of Parliament becomes vacant in the following situations. If a member resigns. Okay, if a member resigns his seat by writing to the Speaker or to the Chairman, as the case may be. So if a person has to resign, he has to give it in writing either to the Speaker or to the Chairman. Second point, the seat is vacant if a member is without permission of the House absent from all meetings for a period of 60 days. In computing the said period, no account is taken of any period during which the House is prorogued or is adjourned for more than 4 consecutive days. So if a person is continuously absent from all the meetings for a period of 60 days, in such case also, the seat can be vacant. Next point, if a member becomes subject to any of the disqualifications which we just read in the Constitution or an Act of Parliament, in that case also, the person will be disqualified of the membership and his seat will be vacant. If a person is already a member of state legislature and is elected to the parliament, he has to vacate his seat from the state legislature in the state legislature or vice versa. Okay, at a time he can be member of one party only, either state legislature or a member of the parliament. Fifth point, if a person is disqualified from being a member on ground of defection under the anti-defection law. Now please underline these lines. What is anti-defection law? According to the anti-defection law, when a member of a house gives up the membership of his party, that means he is being unfaithful, he is not loyal to his party, or votes against the direction given by the party to which he belongs. Okay, he is not following the directions given by his party and he is acting against that, he is voting against that, he shall be disqualified from being a member of that particular house, provided there is not a split in the party with at least one third of its members. So in this case also, in case of defection under the anti-defection law, a person's seat will be vacant. Now with this, we complete studying the Lok Sabha. So we studied its term, the composition, the qualifications for membership, we studied disqualification of membership and the vacation of seats. So in our next class, girls, we will study about the various parliamentary procedures. Good day.